What's really nice about SIRT6 is not only decrease the pressure of the vitrum, but it can regenerate the ganglional cells that are damaged in glaucoma.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Genflow Biosciences CEO, Dr. Eric Leire. Eric, very good to speak with you. You announced a new development program targeting eye health. Tell us a little bit more about that.
We're quite excited about this program. The eye is a logical step for us in our stage of development. Eye is interesting for gene therapy because it's a closed compartment. There's no off-target issues. It goes totally in the eye. There's no immunogenicity issues. So there's a lot of products that have been gene therapy that have been approved in ophthalmology. Furthermore, we have been working in parallel to the development of our AAVs for the liver. We have been working on mRNA. And this mRNA is perfect now for the eyes. It seemed that the first approach for gene therapy for the eyes, we're using AAVs, and they're a little bit irritating. And mRNA has much better potential for the eyes.
You're leveraging your SIRT6 therapy for this, Eric. So really optimizing SIRT6 across all platforms.
Yes. So you remember we have a patent on a variant of SIRT6 that only found in centenarian. So that put us in a special place. This mutation of SIRT6 has a lot of significant advantage versus the wild type that you and I maybe share. And for only in centenarian. In the eye, there's some very recent publication, American publication and Chinese publication, that show that SIRT6 has a huge potential in the eye. The potential to really change the treatment paradigm of glaucoma. Glaucoma is a disease of the posterior part of the eye, so after the vitrum, and there's too much pressure on the optic nerve, and it's the second cause of blindness. What's really nice about SIRT6 is not only decrease the pressure of the vitrum, but it can regenerate the ganglional cells that are damaged in glaucoma. In addition to that, what's really interesting, it's not only it's interesting for the posterior part of the eye, but from the front part of the eye, it can also play a role with the cornea. And that's our entry door. The cornea has a lot of pathologies and mostly linked with the endothelium of the cornea. With age, the endothelium deteriorates, we lose the endothelium, and you have multiple pathologies. Even a lower hanging fruit could be the preservation of the cornea. When you do transplantation, you get the cornea and they preserve in a medium. In this medium, most of the cornea lose a lot of endothelial cells. The end result is the fact that a lot of the transplants are wasted. And sometimes you transplant cornea that are not fully functional because the endothelium is not the perfect quality. What we expect is by a simple in vitro assay, so not even using patient, to add our SIRT6 to this preservation medium and help to increase the rate of positive transplantation of cornea. That could be very fast, doesn't require a trial in human. All we have to demonstrate is after 15 days in the medium, we do better in terms of preservation of the endothelium. We look with a microscope, an histologist is looking at the quality of the endothelium and say, okay, yes, a significant better endothelial quality in the transplant. So multiple of possibility, a small market that we can access very fast, cornea that can be done with an eye drop, and glaucoma that requires a more complex mRNA that will be given through injections and the posterior part of the eye.
So Eric, tell us what's planned for this new development program, what we should be looking out for.
We are starting a collaboration with a company which has expertise in ophthalmology. We signed an MTA. We'll start first by the preservation and move to cornea and glaucoma. And we expect to build some kind of ophthalmology franchise. Ophthalmology is quite interesting market. It's a specialized market with few actors, but with good margin and huge unmet need. So we think we can really play a major role in this. Again, very exciting program that does not require, in addition, a lot of expenses because we can build from, for example, the work we've done already on mRNA.
Eric, I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you very much, Stefan.
That's Dr. Eric Leire. He's the CEO of Genflow Biosciences.